All right, well, welcome inside our Philly Dunkin Music Lounge. Jessie, Alt 104.5, and we've got Mount Joy here. Big hometown throwdown this weekend at the Mann, and it's great to have you guys back. We'll talk after you guys play us some songs. Is that cool?
Yeah, thank you, Jessie.
Do it.
Find me a lane to drive through in a Halloween costume. I'm an astronaut without you. We're twisting our way to the back of the bar. You're locking the door into the star. Stripping you down to your jewelry, breaking the what a life under big stars and a good woman in charge. Got me falling in, got me falling in art. So come on, baby, let's do this right.
It's like it's great for sound, I guess, but it's really dead. So when you guys clap, it's like, whoa, it's like a trip. You had to be there in case you weren't. All right, here's a song called Astrovan.
Smoking cigarettes on rooftops in fishnets in the morning with the moon still glow. And here comes Jesus in an Astrovan rolling down the strip of Gaby snow while Jerry plays. Alright, mama, you're afraid I'll be put along the way. But I don't wanna see those tears again. You know Jesus drives an Astrovan. Astrovan. Yes, it does. I said, angels on the roof, I know I've made it. When my doobie smoking, Jesus put my name upon his guest list. Says, son, you're famous in heaven. Maybe you're famous in heaven. Maybe there is no heaven. And maybe we're all alone together now. And I don't wanna see those tears again. You know, Jesus drives an Astrovan. Again, you know Jesus drives an Astrovan.
Awesome. Thank you guys very much. All right. Well, if you guys want to, like, I don't know,
talk amongst yourselves.
Do your favorite activity.
Matt has to tune.
Unless it's something super weird, that don't do that. But
actually, you don't want to mute me?
How about them Phillies, guys?
Right? Fighting.
How about that?
Crazy.
Man, that was nuts the other night. It was
no
like,
hitter?
But like, it was so emotional on all cylinders because the guy from the minors came up. He hit a home run, like first pitch, first at bat. And then Nick Castellanos, 200th career home run. His kid is like the mayor of Citizens Bank Park. Like, if you ever watched the games, like Liam, his son.
That's awesome.
He's everywhere.
He's always behind the plate, like doing like the stuff with his dad. He's like, yeah. And then they show him on camera, like running around, talking to people. I'm like, he's nuts. He's wild.
What are the standings right now? Like, where are the Phillies? It's hard to keep track sometimes because we tour so much that it's hard to like.
I think they're like at the top of the wild card.
Okay, so they're right now. If the season ended today, they would be in the playoffs.
Yeah. So okay. They're yeah, and then they. But I think the wild card's a little different this year. Like, they're doing three teams or something, if anybody wants to correct me.
They've done that for a couple
of years. I think last year was maybe the first year.
Okay.
Or the year before. I don't know. Someone at home yelling at
the
screen.
But they're catching the Braves, let's be real. We're not thinking wild card.
Yeah.
Although the Braves are pretty good.
Yeah, quite good.
Dude. I was there for the game when they won. Like, it was like 19-4 or something. I forget. Right. But I think it was the Nats. But it was like...
crushed him.
Oh my god, it was so much fun. It was such a party.
That's awesome.
And then Shaq did a DJ set. So
wait, yes.
I was
yes,
there.
My DJ was there.
In the center, like
whoa.
Which like what a guy.
What yeah. a dude.
Like, is he the coolest person ever?
Like, and then I grabbed the dirt from like the infield and I put it in my pockets.
Yeah,
as you
to
do.
Savor the moment.
Yes.
You should make a little like hourglass with
dude,
that.
Dude, I put it in an hourglass at home.
No way.
And I'm gonna tweet you the picture. It's in my kitchen. I came
incredible.
Home and I just kept unloading it.
How much did you take?
A lot. And then you know
You'd
what I...
You unload it?
Yes. And then you know what I did too? All the people that were walking out to get out, I was like, here you go.
Oh, you gave
I
them
just took
some.
It and went, here
right.
you go.
I'm sure they appreciated that.
There's a couple of them
yeah.
that work there.
Wow.
Here you go.
That's pretty cool. It's a very Philly thing for sure.
I am Philly.
Yeah. That's incredible.
Yeah.
Well, I remember I'm pretty sure, Jessie, you did it the last time we were here, but it was a long time ago, and we were way more nervous.
I was going to say, save it for the pod.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But...
yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, sorry, we can do it. We can do this after. Yeah. I just feel like now we're chatting.
Dude,
I
know.
I want to jump
in. You
want
to just talk?
I know, I kind of want to, but I'm like, don't do it.
Rules are rule.
I break them a lot, all right, so.
We'll play a song and try it again.
Oh, we have one more for you guys, and then we'll jump into it all, I guess. All right, here's Silver Lining.
Thank you. on the mountain, caught on the rail line. Up on the mountain, caught on the rail line. My brother, let the harvest be. Drink your wine, smoke your weed, my brother. Let the harvest be. And wave your silver line very close to your skin. But if it's the drugs, the women, the wine, the weed, the love, it's everything I owe. Just take it.
Just talking about the Phillies. So the last time I saw you, it was right outside Citizens Bank Park. What was it, Live and Drive-In?
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was something.
COVID times, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was something. It was a really cool concept though. Mm-hmm. I mean, to think about it, like everybody had their cars, like you were allowed to kind of like sit on your roof and just see the show. That was awesome.
Yeah.
They had it like, I guess they had like the radio you could listen to the music. It was such a confusing time, but I thought it was really cool.
Yeah, there were no actual speakers. You had to listen to it through your car radio, which had a delay. And I remember like watching the drums go like, and then you would hear like,
phew. Yes, yes.
There was just like, so everyone was kind of dancing off beat and like playing to like a bunch of Ford Tauruses. It was weird, but
I remember being out of my car, like kind of dancing and boogieing, getting too close to the section next to me, and then like security's like, "You guys need to go back." And mm-hmm. we were like, "Okay," like that was really fun.
But yes. People loved it. Like there was nothing else to do at the time.
Nothing, and it was so confusing.
It was.
It was like, but I think back and I'm like, wow, that was kind of like a historical thing because it'll probably never happen again. And the way they put that together, though, it was like it was really, really neat. So that's like the last time we talked. And since then, you're like selling out Red Rock shows and WTF.
WTF, indeed.
That's right.
Yeah, it's been good. I also, not to go backwards, but I feel like we and a few other bands are responsible for like figuring out how to do those concerts, because at first it was through the car, and then people realized like, just put a PA up.
Yeah.
And by the end of COVID, we were like just fully playing to a PA, and like maybe there'd be cars, but like people would be outside of them. But yeah, that was early enough in the process where people were really conscientious about social distancing and stuff like that. And they were trying everything they could, but
they tested it out with you guys. Cause then like, I think AJR did it, and then like Lotus. And by the time it was Lotus, it was like, okay, everybody can just get out. And like security.
Yeah, we
not...
were the guinea pigs a little bit on that. Yeah. That's okay.
And like pigeons playing ping pong. But anyway, so this is so awesome. So tomorrow and Sunday, you guys are going to be at Skyline Stage of the Man. So you teamed up with a bunch of different charities. And I love the post that you guys put up. So the picture's with Jason Kelsey. But you've got his charity. You've got Connor Barwin also sharing Excess. Can you kind of go into what these charities are and what kind of made you go with them?
Yeah. I mean, I'll start with Connor's Make the World Better. We've worked with him before. And, you know, I just think it's something, obviously living in the city here, like I think building safe spaces and honestly just places that kids and families can feel good about enjoying in the city is such a like an immediate impact and just something that we feel good about. And Connor's awesome, so it feels good to help that cause out. And then, you know, Jason Kelsey came to a show we did for Philly Music Festival in Ardmore. Got a chance to meet him, and he was he's just the best guy. Yeah. His Be Philly charity is helping public schools here in the city. And again, just something we feel really strong about is trying to improve the public school system here in Philadelphia and give it the resources it deserves and needs to, hope to, I guess sort of obvious why we'd want to do that. So I feel really strongly about that. And then also Sharing Excess is an interesting charity. If you haven't heard of it, they are working to sort of bridge the gap between food insecurity and all the food that we waste. Because if we were able to bridge that gap, we could end hunger. So easier said than done, but you know, there's something like 34 million Americans, I think, that experience food insecurity. And if we have enough food to feed them, then it feels like we should be putting our heads together to try to make easy solutions to really improve people's lives. So we're doing, for that specifically, we're doing a food drive. So if you could bring, non-perishable food items to the man.
So, okay, so we can bring them to the man, and then you're going to have little like pop-up stations where we can give them to distribute.
Just throw canned beans at our manager, Jack. And yeah.
I love the man, dude. Oh, it's such a vibe. It's such a great venue. Noah Kahn played there. You guys came out on stage with Noah Kahn and the song Emily, and everybody, like, I'm on all these like Reddit threads like, dude, when is Mount Joy gonna release this? Or when is Noah Kahn gonna release this?
That's a good question.
Do we know?
We don't know.
Come on.
Well, everybody's doing a lot of things right now. But no, we love Noah. Yeah, we wrote that song. We had a barn during COVID out in Malvern, I guess is technically
cool.
What it is. We were on tour and we didn't know where to go, so we came back home and Matt and I got a barn, and Noah came down from Vermont, I guess. He's in the sticks. Yeah. And we wrote a song. And that was like a couple years ago, and we've just been kind of working on it ever since. And that's
the only sticks too. And there were lots of sticks where we were,
pre-sticks,
so we took credit, obviously,
for sure. Yeah, this is way before the sticks. Yeah,
dude, that's a perfect matchup. Wait, how do you guys know him?
He was a big Mount Joy fan.
Whoa!
Early on, we played some festival in like Gloucester. I don't know if I'm saying that right, in Massachusetts, and he played before us. And I remember him wearing that Mountjoy t-shirt proudly. He was repped a beanie for a while too. For a long time, Mountjoy beanie. Yeah, we got some good photos of him in
that. That's so cool.
Yeah.
All right. Well, and I do want to say, Matt, your background knowledge with like the music industry and like all that kind of stuff, it's so amazing. You should do like a seminar for young musicians. Dude,
sign
seriously.
Me up. Yeah.
Like, I'm you'd down. Be great. And then it was funny when I started reading the article, I think it was like a Northwestern. And I'm like, okay, college students, like, you are helping them. So,
yeah, I did something you know what's really funny is I did something at Northeastern. And this is a really quick, funny story. But one of my roommates, and it ties in briefly to music because he was actually the drummer when I first wrote Silver Lining. But like, I became really good friends with this guy probably because of this day in part, because that was so funny. But one of the first days of college, he'd come from Seattle, really aloof guy. And super smart, but, you know, West Coast, like, out to lunch kind of thing. And he was like, we were talking about where we were going to school, which was Northeastern, which was in Boston.
Northeastern, I think.
And no, no, it's okay. But so he literally thought that he was going to Northwestern. like he was fully in college.
That's
like,
so
and he was like, wait, that's where we're going. Wait, I was like, no, what? That's like in Chicago, man. It's a whole different thing.
God. Oh my God.
He's like, it's like, and you know, there's a much better reputation. I probably shouldn't say this on radio, but there is, Northwestern has a better reputation.
I knew the name, than, so that's like what I immediately associated.
And I was like, yeah, you didn't get in there. Yeah, this is the JV version of it.
I was gonna say, you know, it's like you got the Acme brand of like something that's that.
But Northeastern's an incredible school. I shouldn't say it's a JV version of anything. I think it's an amazing school for different reasons. I just thought that was such a funny story. Whenever I hear Northwestern and Northeastern get confused, I always just think of his face when he was like Googling. He was incredible.
That's something I would do, clearly. Yo, it's so good to see you. You guys, it's been a while. And congrats on all the success. This has been amazing to watch you guys do that. You just do it trucking along, and like, it's hard for people to get somewhere in the business, and you just did it and you're doing it.
Well, you guys helped. I remember the first time we played Philadelphia, we played Johnny Brenda's.
Yeah.
And I was nervous as hell, but we did one of these sessions and it was just the start of us in Philly. So
I know. I remember I was playing like on the New Music Discovery show back in the old station. And like, somebody's like, well, they're from Valley Forge. So, you know, I go, yeah, I know that area. I'm King of Prussia. Like, and you guys are just like low key silent killers. Like, just did it. No one was paying attention. Well, everybody was, especially Noah Kahn, since he's a fan.
He's a huge fan.
All right. Well, really excited about the show. Anybody here going to those shows tomorrow, Sunday? Yeah. All right, it's gonna be great.
Well, wait, time out. There's only like three people here. I'm just making sure. It doesn't sound like a huge reaction. There's many more people around the area going, I hope.
That was maybe like, not.
We're gonna be there.
Yeah. Okay. Just people know. Okay.
Everybody knows.
We're in a very small room.
I hope Jason Kelsey's there. And yeah, you guys rock. Thank you so much for being here. Give it up one more time for Mount Joy, Philly Dunkin Music Lounge, Alt 104.5.
Thank you.